Over the years, I've had quite a lot of people saying that these types of screwdrivers are unsafe, but they can't actually back up them comments with any facts. And I've done a search on Google and Yahoo trying to find accidents with neon screwdrivers, and I can't actually find any. That doesn't mean that there's not been any. It is possible for you to have an accident with any tool if you misuse it. But these neon screwdrivers can be very useful, especially for the DIYer, especially because they are only 99 pence each, or in that instance, about £5. Obviously, you do have to be careful with these. You can get some of these that are 12 volts and not 240 volts. And I do know somebody that once got a 12 volt one, tested it on a 230 volt supply, and it did go with a bang. He did not get injured. All he needed was a clean pair of underpants. So the screwdriver actually did what it was supposed to do. There's an internal fuse in there, or a resistor, that blew, and it didn't actually injure him whatsoever, so he escaped totally unarmed. The GS38 approved voltage detectors are not perfect because the tips are shielded and there's only 3 millimeters of the tip showing. In a lot of circumstances, you can't actually get them in to test the terminals. So all these people that think that a GS38 approved voltage tester is the holy grail of electrical testing for safety, let me tell you, it isn't. So these screwdrivers do have a place, they can be useful, especially for the DIYer. Some of the comments in the past have said, well, what if your apprentice drops that in a puddle of water and hands it to you, you use it, you get electrocuted. Well, if your apprentice does that, not only does he want to go kicking, he wants to go and get another job because he's obviously not suitable to be an electrician. A lot of people say that electricians don't use these, and I can tell you that quite a lot of professional electricians do use these because I have seen them using them. For a quick test, these are very quick, and although they're not as reliable as other means, they can give you a quick indication whether or not something is live before you go touching it. People have also said that what happens if you're using these outside, you can't see the neon. Well, basically that's just common sense. If you're using anything outside that you can't see, you do have to take extra precautions. I've just rigged this up. This is 230 volts. Then I can just show you how these work. That is 230 volts, and on there we have a test window. If we place the neon in there and we put our finger on the top, you can see that the neon illuminates. So that is telling us that that is live, obviously. Same goes with this one. In the test window, touch the top and that illuminates. This neon screwdriver is slightly more expensive. This one costs about £5, but it is incredibly useful. If we take it and we touch our finger on the end there, it actually illuminates, saying that we've got a circuit. So this can be used for continuity testing. Not only that, if you grab it by the tip and put it close to something that is live, it actually illuminates as well. So that is incredibly useful, because you can actually use that for tracing breaks in cables, etc. Not only that, but if you touch that into a terminal that is live, it actually lights up really brightly, and that is without touching the end of the screwdriver. So it doesn't need a circuit through your body to actually work. As soon as you put it on something that's live, it actually illuminates straight away. So for £5, that is a very useful piece of kit. You can then get non-contact voltage detectors like this one. Simply twitch that on, put it next to something that's live, and it bleeps to tell you that it's live. We then have the GS38 approved voltage tester. This has an auto test function on it, so we're just going to test it's working, which it is. We're then just going to test the lead by doing a continuity test. We're now going to test these two terminals. Obviously, I know which one's live. This is the live one. That is the neutral. And obviously, there's absolutely nothing there at all because the probes are too big to fit in the test window. If you are a professional electrician, obviously, you have to use a GS38 approved tester because that is what is advised by the Health and Safety Executive in the UK. But if you want my opinion, I'm not keen on them for that very reason. That you can't get them in to test a lot of things. You can't even make contact with the terminals to test if that is live or not. The reason why I like neon screwdrivers is very simple. They're very inexpensive. You can pick them up anywhere, and any test is better than no test at all. You have to remember that a lot of videos that I make are to help out DIYers. If you read a DIY book, the majority of them do not even say that you need to make a test to ensure the circuit is not live before you work on it. So even using a neon screwdriver is better than using nothing at all. I'd like to thank you for watching this video, and if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel.